Okay, Bob Swanson here, ICC Astronomy Instructor, and we've got a good one for you in Module 7. This is one of my favorite simulations. It's one of my favorite topics in astronomy, the HR Diagram. It doesn't get much better. The HR Diagram brings together a lot of things that we've been studying already this semester. We relate the temperature and the size of a star with its luminosity, and really that's a large part of what winds up being on the HR Diagram. So of course you're in the Module 7 area of your Canvas site, and when you click on Module 7 Lab Activity, it'll take you to the actual activity, which offers the student guide, it offers a link to the simulation, and it also offers a link to the lab quiz. Again, spend time with the background material. I can't stress this enough. So when you click on the student guide, obviously you can print out the student guide. You click on this link, and that's going to take you to the actual HR Diagram Lab. And here's where you have the access to the background material. I'm going to take you through this relatively in depth because you're going to be getting a lot of your answers for the lab quiz from the background material. So the first link is to Spectral Classification. This may have been a little while since we've talked about this. You may have encountered this earlier in the textbook, but stars have different spectral classes. If you remember, there was a mnemonic, I always think of that as only bad astronomers forget generally known mnemonics. O, B, A, F, G, K, M. Those are ways of classifying stars based on their temperature. And this page explains how astronomers are able to determine the temperature of stars just based on their spectra. And that's why astronomy is just such a cool subject, because you take these little pinpricks of light, these little bits of light in the sky that are so minuscule that you can't see them during the day. They're out there, but our sun just washes them all out. But those little tiny pinpricks of light, when you run them through a telescope and a spectrometer, you can produce these spectra which give you so much information. And the information we'll focus on mainly today is the temperature. So based on the spectrum that you wind up seeing, you wind up getting generally what's called a continuous spectrum, all the different colors in the visible range. However, there will be a few little dark spots, and that's because of absorption that occurs in the outer atmosphere of the star. And based on the strength of those absorption lines, you can determine the temperature of the star, because not all stars, a lot of them have the same absorption lines, but sometimes the absorption lines of certain elements are stronger than others, and that tells you a lot about the temperature of the star. And so that's essentially how astronomers figure out the temperatures of the stars. And then they give them a spectral class. So our star is a good old G2. Now what you're going to wind up doing in this activity is you'll be using this little gadget, which helps you to just figure out the different spectral classifications. So for example, our star is around 5800 Kelvin. That's the surface temperature. And that's what it shows you, the effective temperature, the surface temperature. It shows you the spectral type. It's a G2, it's a G star. Again, it's not the hottest, those are O's. It's not the coolest, those are M's. Our star, the sun, is sort of in the middle. And you also can get a feel for the color of our star. You know, it's kind of a whitish yellow. And then you'll just use the slider, because you'll be asked several questions about what's the spectral class of a particular temperature star. Or you might be asked, what's the temperature of a certain spectral class star? Or what's the color of a particular spectral class? So just use the slider and see how it changes the color of the star, see how it changes the temperature of the star, and the spectral class. Those all kind of change in tandem together. Okay, moving on. So that again was the spectral classification. Now the other thing is luminosity. Luminosity, you're asked a couple of questions about luminosity in the lab quiz. You know, what is luminosity? Luminosity is essentially the energy that a star produces in 1 second. So what this means is that a hot star essentially will produce more energy. If you have two stars that are the same size, a hotter star is going to be producing more energy per second. On the flip side of that, you could have stars that are of equal temperature, equal surface temperature, but one that's larger is going to have more surface to emit energy from, so it's going to actually emit more energy than a smaller star. And you get a chance to play around with the luminosity. That's what L stands for. of a star based on its temperature and its radius, the size of the star. And so you start out with a star not unlike our Sun. It's got a temperature of, well, actually let me change it down to make it, exactly like our Sun. It's a G2. Notice in solar units, you know, this relationship is luminosity is related to 4 times pi, but those are just constants, times the radius, times another constant, times the temperature to the 4th power. And you can look down here in the solar units area. Notice right now my star is 1 solar radius, and it's 1 solar temperature. It's our Sun. And sure enough, the luminosity of this star is 1 times the luminosity of our Sun. That's that little circle with the dot in the middle stands for. We're comparing everything, all the different stars that we can make, and we're going to compare it to our Sun. So in this case, our star is the Sun. And therefore, since it's the same radius and the same temperature, it has the same luminosity. And what you do with this is you can play around with the radius. You can increase the radius. Make it twice as large. See how it affects your luminosity. So this is a star that would be the same temperature as our Sun, but be twice as large. And notice that it essentially quadruples the luminosity. This star, same temperature as our Sun, is now 4 times more luminous. So you play around with that slider, and that's how you work that part of it. Now finally, the Hertzsprung-Russell Diagram tab for the background material. Again, just describes what the Hertzsprung-Russell Diagram is. It's not a star chart. It is a graph that relates the temperature and the luminosity of stars. And by doing so, by using a large number of stars and putting them on this chart, on this graph, certain patterns develop. And it's your task in the actual simulation to get a better feel for what the patterns are and what the relationship is within the graph. So I'm going to cut this one off. This just kind of goes through the background material, and I'll do a part 2 video which will actually step us through the simulation.